According to your debrief, most of your incarceration was spent at a secret military facility outside Damascus. What landmarks or structural details can you give us to help pinpoint?
8 months ago, you were smuggled overland to an enemy operating base in Afghanistan. Now, after so many years, what prompted
you? Sergeant Brody, my name is Carrie Matheson. I served as a case officer in Iraq. Your picture was on our MIA wall. I saw it every day for 5 years. It's good to meet you in person.
Thank you, ma'am.
I'm sorry we were unable to find you sooner.
I appreciate that.
I'd like to start with the first few days of your captivity, if you don't mind.
Not at all.
How soon after you were taken did the interrogations begin?
Pretty much right away.
What did they want to know?
Anything I could tell them about U.S. ground operations, supply routes, communication codes, rules of engagement.
When you were debriefed in Germany, you said you gave up no such information.
My SEER training was excellent.
And Corporal Walker?
Ma'am?
Did he give anything up?
We were never interrogated together, so I don't know.
But still, you must have wondered, especially after you learned of his death.
I'm assuming there's a point to all this, Carrie.
Well, there is, sir. As you know, the first 72 hours after a soldier's capture are critical. What he knows can be used by the enemy during that period to devastating effect. The point is, Sergeant Brody stopped being a source of actionable intelligence fairly quickly, and yet he was kept alive for almost 8 more years. I'd like to ask him if he knows why.
I often wondered that myself.
Who is your interrogator?
An Al-Qaeda commander. His name was Zayadi.
Zayadi?
That's what he told me his name was, anyway.
Was this him?
No.
But you know who this man is.
Of course. Every Marine in country was briefed on high-value targets.
Did you ever meet him?
Abu Nazir.
Was he ever present during any of your interrogations?
No.
Look again.
No, I never met him.
What about Walker? Did he ever mention Abu Nazir?
No,